Hello everyone, I am Sachin Rathod, working as assistant professor in mechanical engineering department from Walchand of Technology, Solapur College. Today we have to see the numericals on velocity and acceleration in mechanism by using the relative velocity method. The learning outcome of this session is student will able to calculate the velocity and acceleration of given mechanism. Had given us one numerical. The PQRS is a 4-bar link mechanism in which PS is fixed and the length of the link, they had given us a dimension PQ is equal to 62.5 mm, QR 175 mm, RS 112.5 mm, PS 200 mm. The cranks PQ is the crank, rotates at 10 radian per second, means they are given us a angular velocity of PQ is equal to 10 radian per second in clockwise direction. Draw the velocity and acceleration diagram. Angle QPS is equal to 60 degree and Q and R lies on the same side of the PS. Find the angular velocity and angular acceleration of Q1 and RS. So as per the given data, we can easily draw the space diagram by using. So, and this PQ rotates in the clockwise direction, they had given us with 10 radian per second. The value of this omega is 10 radian per second. So, we have to find out the angular velocity and angular acceleration of link QR and RS. For that purpose, we have to draw the velocity diagram as well as the acceleration diagram. So, first of all, we can draw the velocity diagram. For drawing the velocity diagram, just remember these things. The velocity of any link which is having the rotary motion, the velocity of that link should be perpendicular to that motion, perpendicular to the link. Suppose PQ, first of all, we will draw one point on the space at which the velocity is zero. So P and S are the fixed points, so at that point the velocity is zero. So suppose one point we have taken in the space, at that point P S, okay, this is a PS at which the velocity is zero. Next, PQ makes the angular velocity of omega in clockwise direction. The value is 10 radian per second. Now we are drawing the velocity diagram. So we have to find out the velocity of this link. They had given us angular velocity. So we are knowing this is the space diagram. Space diagram. Now they had given us angular velocity. Otherwise, simply make one table in which link, radius, velocity, okay, if you consider the link PQ, QR and RS, the radius of the link PQ is 62.5 mm is equal to 0.0625, the link QR 0.175, this radius in meter, and the link RS is 0.1125 meter, and the velocity, the link velocity PQ, link velocity, we can find out that given us angular velocity of PQ. We are knowing V is equal to R omega, that is the, we have to find out the velocity of PQ, therefore radius of PQ into angular velocity of PQ. The radius of the PQ is 0.0625 into the angular velocity of PQ, that gives us a 10 radian per second into 10, so we are getting 0.625 meter per second. So we are getting the angular velocity of PQ is 0.625 meter per second. So we are knowing the magnitude as well as the direction of velocity of link PQ. So this is a P point, PQ rotates in the clockwise direction. So from the P point, you draw the perpendicular line. So this is a perpendicular line. So from the P point, we have drawn perpendicular line to the PQ link, which is having the magnitude of 0.625. So we are getting the Q point. Next, from the Q point, QR is another link which is having the angular motion. So from the Q point, again, we have drawn the perpendicular line for getting the velocity of Q with respect to R. So from the Q points, draw the perpendicular line. Next one, RS is another link. the velocity of the RS link is perpendicular to that link. So from the R or S, R point we are not knowing. So from the S points, draw the perpendicular line to the link RS. So from the S points, we have drawn the perpendicular line. At this point, we are getting the point R. So in this diagram, we are getting the velocity of Q with respect to P. This will give the velocity of R with respect to S. This will give the velocity of Q with respect to R. So by using this velocity diagram, we can just calculate the value of velocity of RS, velocity of QR. So we are getting the velocity of RS as 0.38 and 0.34. Okay. Now, by using in this table, now we are finding the acceleration diagram. For the drawing the acceleration diagram, in the acceleration diagram, there are the two components, that is the radial component as well as the tangential component. So we have to find out the radial component of each link. So we can just write down the radial component. So radial component is nothing but the V square by R. Now here we are knowing the velocity and radius, so we have to calculate the radial component. So we are getting by calculating 6.25, 0.825 and 1.027. These are the radial component. By calculation, we are finding this radial component. Now we go further for the acceleration diagram. For drawing the acceleration diagram, just there are the two link, that is the radial component and another is a tangential component. So each link having the two component, radial and the tangential. So first of all, one point at which the acceleration is zero, so P and S are the fixed point. So consider any one point at which the acceleration is zero, we can give as a name P dash S dash, at which the acceleration is zero. Next link PQ. PQ rotated with the uniform angular velocity, so it is having the only one component, that is the radial component. So radial component of the PQ is 6.25 and the radial component is parallel to this link. So the Q point is moving parallelly in the downward direction. This will give the radial component. So from the P point, we are getting the Q point in the downward direction. So we will draw the parallel line to this in the downward direction. So we are getting the Q point and having the magnitude is equal to 6.25. So after the Q point, QR is another link. So it is having the two component, perpendicular as well as the tangential and normal or radial. So the Q point, already we had calculated the QR. So the radial component of the QR is 0.825. So the radial component is nothing but the parallel line. So we have to draw the parallel line to this. And the magnitude, this is a Q point. So the radial component of the QR, it is moving in the downward direction. So we are getting the X point below the Q point. So we will give you as a X point and this magnitude is equal to 0.825. This is X point. This is a radial component. Radial and the tangential component are perpendicular to each other. So from the X points, we have to draw the perpendicular line. This is a perpendicular line. But the tangential component, the value we are not knowing, so keep it as it is. Okay, this will give the tangential component, but the magnitude we are not knowing. So the next, consider the next link, that is a QS. It is having the two component, radial as well as the tangential. We are knowing the S point. Then the radial component of the QS is 1.027. This is S point, so the radial component is moving in the downward direction. So we are getting the component below the S point. And for the radial components, we have drawn the parallel line. So parallel to this link, we have drawn the radial component. This is the radial component of RS and the magnitude is 0.127. And perpendicular to this, tangential component will lie. This is a perpendicular. This is the tangential component. So the intersecting point will give you the R point. Radial component of RS, tangential component. If I join this, it will give the acceleration of QR link. And if I join this, it will give the acceleration of PS link. So this radial component, if I shown like this or like this in the downward direction, This is the acceleration of q with respect to r, so it will give the like this direction, radial component of q r. This is in the downward direction, tangential component of q r. Similarly, if I draw a diagram like this, acceleration of r with respect to s, it will give the radial component of r with respect to s, tangential component of r with respect to s, and it is the acceleration of q with respect to p. Like this way, we can find out the acceleration of each limb. So they had asked, find the angular velocity. Angular velocity, this velocity we are knowing, angular velocity and angular acceleration of qr and rs. The angular velocity of qr, velocity we are knowing, v is equal to r omega. This is a qr, radius of qr, angular velocity of qr. We have to find out the angular velocity. Velocity we are knowing, the radius we are knowing. Like this, we can find out the angular velocity and angular acceleration of each limb. So I have taken this reference. Thank you.